Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today I'm going to discuss about the treatment, diagnosis, and prevention of pertussis or whooping cough. In the previous lecture, I have discussed about the properties, pathogenesis, transmission, and sign and symptom of whooping cough. In this lecture, first of all, I am going to discuss the treatment of whooping cough. You know that the choice of drug for the treatment of Bordetella pertussis is azithromycin. You know that azithromycin is an antibiotic protein synthesis inhibitor. It what this do, this drug do, this antibiotic do, it reduces the number of bacteria. It is very important to know. It reduces the number of bacteria, so decrease the risk of secondary complication. It is very important to know. Why? Because there is a lethal effect on the course of the disease. There is a lethal effect on the courses of disease. Why? Because the toxin already damaged the respiratory tract. The bacteria produce toxin, and this toxin have already damaged the ciliated cell of the trachea. So when you prescribe the antibiotics such as azithromycin, it will only reduces the number of bacteria. As a result, risk of secondary complication will not occur, but it will have a little effect on the course of the disease, the duration of the disease. The answer is that because the toxin has already damaged the epithelial, the ciliated cells. Beside the antibiotic, you should also provide supportive care. Supportive care means that you can provide oxygen therapy, suction of the mucus from the trachea. It will help, it will support the patient so that the patient easily breathe and they don't cough. Now, if we talk about the epidemiology of this disease. So, in epidemiology, if we talk about according to the research, about 60 million people are infected and 60 million cases are reported annually throughout the world. In 1940, this disease was a major disease because it has affected all the children below 10 years of age. But due to the introduction of vaccine, DTP vaccine, diphtheria, tetanus, pertussis vaccine, the cases are decline with the passage of time due to immunization. But in 1980s, the cases increased. About 26,000 cases were reported. Now, why? Because this DTF vaccine is now not working, and a new vaccine that is called DTaP vaccine I am going to discuss. Due to this vaccine, the disease once again declined. I am going to discuss the important point here, that you know that PCR, polymerase chain reaction, is the most sensitive test, and it is the most specific test. Due to the introduction or discovery of PCR, the cases increased, reported due to PCR screening, the cases increased. When the when in any area when the disease is present, but you can't diagnose it, you know that it will lead to misconception that disease has already declined. But if you do the PCR, this will help you to diagnose more and more diseases. So what is pseudo epidemics? Pseudo epidemics mean that when you diagnose an area, through different diagnosis tests, and the reported cases are increasing in that area. This is known as pseudo epidemics. In 2012, 42,000 cases were reported due to the introduction of PCR, polymerase chain reaction. So epidemiology and epidemiology, we shortly say that the epidemiology of the whooping cough changes. How it is changes? Because it changes according to the area. In developed country, in US, the cases are declined, but in the developing country, the cases remain at peak due to an immunization. Now, if we talk about the epidemiology, we have talked about the epidemiology. Now, the prevention. For the prevention, there are two types of vaccine available for the whooping cough. The first vaccine is acellular vaccine. Acellular vaccine is called D-tape. Why this is called D-tape? Because D stand for diphtheria, T for tetanus, or AP for acellular pertussis. Actually, D-tape consists of 5 antigen. These 5 antigen are purified from the bacteria. The main immunogen is actually this bacterial toxin. Now, how we prepare the vaccine? Suppose this is the toxin. From this toxin, we remove the ADP ribosylating unit, they will eliminate the ADP ribosylating unit. That what they will do, it will act as an immunogenic, it will produce against this antibody, will be produced, but there will be no disease. You know that this vaccine are made by genetic engineering by introducing 2 amino acid changes. Toxide vaccine retained its antigenicity but lost the pathogenicity. D-tape, I have already discussed you that it is diphtheria, tetanus, acellular pertussis. Actually, why it is called acellular? Because in this, only the protein part, the toxin, are combined and not the live attenuated organism is used. So it is called acellular vaccine. This vaccine is recommended for the all ages. You can doses can be used for 2 month of age, a booster from 12 to 15 months, or you can also give the dose to the children during the time of entering to the school. Now, you know that teenagers are also the victim of this disease. So for teenager, you can use another vaccine. This is called Boostrix. You can use this Boostrix. You can immunize by Boostrix the people age ranges from 10 to 18 years. And another vaccine, Edacils. Edacils is also a vaccine that is available and you can use it. So it was the last lecture about the whooping cough, and in the next lecture I will discuss about the Pasteurella.